How many Muslims in the world? Anybody?
1.57 billion.
Let's just say 10% dislike us or hate us. That means 157 million Muslims hate us. If 10%, 5%, 1% are radicalizing, would kill us.
That's one and a half million
people who are radicalized to the point where they would want to kill us Americans.
Wow, that's that's interesting. Can I see a footnote citation for those figures? Oh, that's where you got them. All right. I wasn't sure. Well, so in the wake of an assault on our freedom and way of life, we have quickly jettisoned the Sixth Amendment right to a fair trial and speedy trial, and the Fifth Amendment's right against self-incrimination. What's next?
This guy ought to be, right now, being interrogated in a very intense way. I'd waterboard him. I don't believe enhanced interrogation is torture. I don't.
You don't believe enhanced interrogation is torture? Because torture, like Tinkerbell, depends on if we believe? So there goes the Eighth Amendment's ban on cruel and unusual punishment. Any freedom lovers want to take a crack at some of the lower ones, your thirds, your fourths?
Should the FBI be allowed to now go into mosques and wiretap and surveil? I think this is a great case for opening up that line of surveillance.
I think that we should be able to put in listening devices in there.
Sure, illegal search and seizure, done! The freedom lovers at Fox are jettisoning amendments like Han Solo dumping cargo to make the jump to light speed at the first sign of Imperial cruisers, right, Chewie? But you know what? Anybody can toss away the lesser-known amendments. Only a true patriot can set a course straight for the first.
We really have to consider, given the fact so many people hate us, that we're going to have to cut off Muslim students from coming to this country for some period of time.
Yes, a religious litmus test for school enrollment, says Fox's most prominent liberal voice. Holy what's left? A prohibition on the unmentioned personal rights in the Constitution that are designated to the people?
I want to know about this wife as well. I don't care if she knew about this. She ought to be in prison for wearing a hijab.
And down goes the Ninth Amendment! Down goes the Ninth Amendment! Ann Coulter doesn't just want a police state, she wants a fashion police state.
We were. And the spontaneous cheers of Watertown residents on Friday night upon the capture of a suspect showed the almost giddy relief that it was all over so soon. But even as we cheer in relief, it's worth remembering that we are a nation that has responded to collective terror by compromising our own civil liberties, by pursuing preemptive violence, and by assuming that entire groups of our fellow citizens are potential enemies who must be monitored. Which leaves me wondering, is there another way to recover from terror?
After the Oak Creek shooting of a Sikh temple, one which many people believe to have been basically a case of American ignorance, misunderstanding about the Sikh religion versus Islam, right, gets right at that core. What can we learn about how to recover?
Well, let's remember that the Oak Creek mass shooting was actually the last incident of domestic terrorism in this country. Yep. And it was committed by a white supremacist who walked into a Sikh house of worship and opened fire. In the wake of that tragedy, we did not hear calls for white people to be profiled. We did not hear Christianity denigrated. We did not see Christians living in fear. The way that our country diagnoses a problem when it's a white perpetrator, it's an individual problem.
Right. Yeah.
When it's a person of color, suddenly an entire community
Correct.
Is deemed right. dangerous.
So is there another way, a better way, for us to respond than the ways that we have sometimes in the past?
Well, I think one of the things that struck me as this whole thing unfolded was, and of course, you know, many, many Muslims around the country, before the identities of the suspects were known, said, please don't let them be Muslim. I mean, I remember growing up, we said the same thing, please don't be black,
yeah.
right? So it's like, because you don't have, as a community, the kind of privilege to declare individuality, to say this is a plural community, this is diversity, and we are all not the same.
I honestly was hoping like that the person wasn't a Muslim. I felt bad because I was caring more about my image rather than, you know, anyone who could have gotten killed.
So how many of you guys in the past sort of 48 hours were sort of sincerely wishing that the perpetrator was not a Muslim or an Arab? Wow.